ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يحده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وبعد خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الحدي حدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. We begin by praising Allah. We praise Him, we seek His help, and we ask for His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evil of ourselves and from the evil consequences of our evil actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, there is none to misguide, and whomsoever Allah leaves to go astray, there is none to guide. And I testify that Allah alone is worthy of worship, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the servant of Allah and his final messenger. After that, the best speech is the book of Allah, and the best guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst of all the affairs are those matters that have been newly introduced into the religion. And all of the newly introduced matters in the religion of Islam are innovations, bid'ah. And all of the innovations are misguidance. All of the misguidance is going astray, and all the going astray is in the fire. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrated to us and mentioned the case of a good sitting companion and an evil companion, a good friend and a bad friend. And he gave an example, a similitude, an example, that the example of the good companion is the example of the perfume seller. If one of us was to live and to stay in the house of a perfume seller, even if we did not buy some perfume from that man, we would still come smelling from his house of perfume. And the example of an evil companion is that of the blacksmith. So if you stay in the house of the blacksmith, even if the blacksmith does not drop on your clothes some coal or some fire and burn you, then most certainly you will come smelling of smoke. This, my brothers and sisters in Islam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon you, is an observed fact of human behavior. The people who you mix with, the people who you take as your companions, the environment that surrounds you, will influence you and will affect you without a doubt. This is why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that every child is born upon the fitrah, the natural disposition and the natural inclination to be good and to worship Allah. Hanifan. But the shayateen, the devils amongst mankind and the jinn, or their parents, made them a Jew or a Christian or a fire worshipper. So the natural condition of the human being is to be inclined to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. But the environment changes that and causes someone to actually be the opposite, to make shirk with Allah, to set up rivals to Allah. Which is the greatest oppression, the greatest wrongdoing, and the greatest tyranny. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us, be careful who you take as your friend, because you will take your deen from your friend. You will take your religion, you will take your way of life from your friend. And this is one of the reasons why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has warned us in His book, do not take the disbelievers as your awliya. Do not take the disbelievers as your awliya. Do not take the Jews and the Christians or the mushrikeen as your awliya. Do not prefer them to the believers. Do not prefer their company to the company of the believers. Do not take them as your, and what is the word awliya? What does it mean? It has a meaning of friendship, close friendship. It has the meaning of your advisor, your protector. The awliya, your wali, that is the one who you go to, you seek protection from, you seek help from, you seek aid from, you seek advice from. When you have a problem, it is the one who is your intimate friend and your protector from whom you seek advice. The one who is close to you and you are close to them. And Allah has forbidden the Muslim, the believer, from taking the unbeliever as their awliya. Allah has forbidden us from having that relationship with the unbelievers. Whether it is us individually, as individuals, or as nations. Or as nations. It is extraordinary to find how many of the Muslim nations boast and say how America, they are our awliya, our allies, our friends. How Britain, France, Germany and Australia and other countries, they are our friends and our allies. And in fact, they will state their enmity and hatred for their own Muslim brothers. And they will state their friendship for the disbelievers. Whereas in fact, my brothers and sisters in Islam, after the issue of Tawheed and Shirk, after the issue of Tawheed and Shirk, which is the most widely discussed topic in the Quran. Most verses in the Quran, the greatest number of verses in the Quran could deal with the topic of Tawheed and Shirk. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about Surah Al-Ikhlas, it is one third of the Quran. The next most widely
discussed topic in the Quran, and that has the most number of verses dedicated to it after the issue of Tawheed and Shirk, is the issue of Walla and Bara. The issue of who we should be allied to and who we should be at enmity with. Who are our friends and who are our enemies?